Legislative Resolution Number 2758 by Senator Parker, mourning the death of Congressman Major Robert Odell Owens, distinguished citizen and devoted member of his community. Whereas, it is the custom of this legislative body to pay tribute to citizens of the state of New York whose life, work, and civic endeavor serve to enhance the quality of life in their communities in the great state of New York. And whereas, it is with great sorrow and deep regret that this legislative body records the passing of Congressman Major Robert Odell Owens, noting the significance of his purposeful life and accomplishments. And whereas, Major Owens, who served in the House of Representatives until 2007, died on Monday, October 21, 2013. And whereas, Major Owens was born in Collierville, Tennessee on June 28, 1936, to Ezekiel and Edna Owens. In 1956, the year he graduated from Morehouse, Mr. Owens married Ms. Ethel Werfel and was later remarried to the former Maria Cupril. And whereas, after earning a master's degree in library science in 1957 from Atlanta University, which later became Clark Atlanta, Mr. Owens moved to New York City and worked as a librarian in Brooklyn from 1958 until the mid-1960s. As a librarian, he became a fixture in the Brooklyn community, working as a crusader for working-class families, which led him into fighting poverty as part of the Major John D. Lindsay administration in the 1960s, and eventually into a position as New York State Senator. And whereas, after serving Brooklyn as a state senator, Major Owens ran successfully for the congressional seat previously held by Congresswoman Shirley Chisholm, which he continued to serve for 24 years. Among his many achievements include the passage of the American with Disabilities Act and many years of increased funding for the historically black colleges and universities. And whereas, after his retirement from Congress, Major Owens returned to the world of academia and taught at Megger Evers College in central Brooklyn. In his death, Brooklyn had lost a true hero who led by example and cared deeply for the community he lived in for so many years. And whereas, Congressman Major Owens distinguished himself in his profession and by his sincere dedication and substantial contribution to the welfare of his community. And whereas, Mr. Owens is survived by his wife Maria, his children Chris, Millard, and Jeffrey, his brothers Ezekiel Jr., Mac and Bobby, his sister Edna, stepson Carlos, stepdaughter Cecilia, four grandchildren, and four step-grandchildren. And whereas, armed with a humanistic spirit and imbued with a sense of compassion, Congressman Major Owens leaves behind a legacy which will long endure the passage of time and will remain as a comforting memory to all he served and befriended. Now, therefore, be it resolved that this legislative body pauses deliberations to mourn the death of Congressman Major Robert Odell Owens, distinguished citizen and devoted member of his community, and be further resolved that a copy of this resolution suitably engrossed be transmitted to the family of Congressman Major Robert Odell Owens.
Senator Parker on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. On the resolution, I want to thank you for an opportunity to celebrate the work and all of the efforts of my Congressman Major Owens. Growing up, Major Owens was my congressman. He was the person, you know, spoke at my graduations and somebody who I knew to be fighting for me, the person that my family went to when we were having difficulties of any kind, and someone who I always felt was always on call. How appropriate is it that today, being the week of the birth of the Reverend Martin Luther King, that we have the opportunity here in the State Senate to honor Major Owens, Dr. King, and Nelson Mandela. And it is no small stretch to put Major Owens in that category. This is somebody who in his own right was a conscience of the Congress in the time that he served there. He was a tireless fighter on behalf of education. Coming from, you know, we see oftentimes librarian as just keeper of books, but he was more than that. He was a keeper of knowledge. He was somebody who always cared about our young people. And in fact, he's most famous in the district for his Martin Luther King Jr. Commission. They gave out scholarships to young people. They provided educational opportunities for young people. That provided upliftment in the community around economic development and access to opportunity. Major Owens was somebody also in the context of political empowerment who was always on the vanguard. He is somebody who encouraged young people like myself to be involved in politics, who oftentimes fought for candidates that nobody else wanted to fight for. He was oftentimes on the side of the underdog. In fact, representing the 21st Senatorial District in Brooklyn, that is a primarily Caribbean community, and in the part of which I live, I remember my first political campaign working for Una Clark, Una S.T. Clark. And Una was running as an insurgent candidate at the time. And the county was against her, and the only, you know, major elected official in that area who lived in that area who was supporting Una Clark was Major Owens. Unfortunately, in 1991, he suffered a heart attack and had a triple or quadruple bypass. It was like, you know, really, really serious heart operation. He was in the hospital for about a week. And I remember this because I went and got him myself. He went directly from the hospital when they released him to do a train stop for Una Clark. That's the kind of dedication that this man had, that his health wasn't even as important as it was the fight for justice and the fight for inclusion. As we saw that the election of Una Clark as the first Caribbean immigrant ever elected to the city council was for the political incorporation of Caribbean people in Brooklyn and in New York. And how fitting is it now that Caribbean immigrant's daughter is now succeeding Major Owens in the U.S. Congress, my new Congresswoman, Yvette D. Clark. And so we're here to celebrate not just the work and the life of Major Owens, but his after, the things that he has left behind, the sense of justice, the institutions, the sense of political empowerment that Brooklyn has because Major Owens was there. We are better as a people, as Brooklynites, and as New Yorker because Major Owens served.
Thank you, Senator Parker. Senator Smith on the resolution.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. And let me thank my colleague, Senator Parker, for bringing this resolution to the floor today. As so many of my colleagues spoke so eloquently about Nelson Mandela yesterday and today, Major Owens so too deserves those same type of accolades. Many may not realize that Major Owens has had an impact on many of the elected officials, in particular of color, that sit in this chamber and the assembly chamber. As we have, so many of us on this side of the aisle have joined the fight to provide pre-K for our young students, our young people today, Major Owens took up the fight for community action programs back in the 60s and the 70s. I myself had the ability to go to Washington, and it was Major Owens who decided to take up that fight when so many of our community action programs were being threatened. To some of my colleagues, community action programs may not mean a lot, but in neighborhoods of Southeast Queens and in Bed-Stuy and Harlem, community action programs is a difference between being caught up and being sent to jail or in some negative activity, or being able to sit in this chamber and advocate for opportunities for young people to come forward this day. Senator Parker laid out all the facts that need to be presented on behalf of Congressman Major Owens. I stand today not only to support the resolution, but to make sure that my colleagues take the time, when you have an opportunity to Google Senator Congressman Major Owens, do so. Read the rich history that he has contributed to, and I guarantee you will find some nexus between his life and yours that would allow you at some point in time to not only pray for his family, but also to thank God for the presence and the impact that he had on our state and our city. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Smith. The question is on Resolution 2758. But before that, Senator Montgomery would like to speak on the resolution.
Mr. President, I rise to also thank my colleague, Senator Parker, for introducing this resolution, but I just want to correct the record for this moment. Congressman Major Owens was my congressman. So And long, long before I came to Albany as an elected official, as an advocate in the community, working on behalf of children and families in Brooklyn and across the state, it was Senator Major Owens that was our go-to legislator in the state legislature. And he was not only the person who supported us and sponsored legislation on our behalf, but he also taught us how to be effective leaders as it relates to working and advocating for our communities. And let me just say that Major Owens was a Morehouse man. And so every time the Morehouse choir came to Brooklyn, wherever they were, if Major Owens was in the audience, he would dutifully get up and go and join the choir. So I was very, very touched by that, because not many people feel that strong about their alma mater. But as the parent of a Morehouse young person, one of the things that the president of the college said to my son's class as he was entering Morehouse was that we did not bring you to Morehouse to be an intellectual elite. We are here to teach you and to prepare you to be leaders of your people. And I was extremely, extremely touched by that, because as I look at Major Owens, I can see what Morehouse means to the young people in this nation, especially young men of color. He exhibited that. He was in every single way the person that I believe the president of Morehouse was talking about. He was truly a Morehouse man. And I appreciate that because of so much that he meant, not only to me personally, but to the people that I worked with, those of us who have been part of a struggle. We did not always know how to access power. He was there for us to help us understand and open the doors. So I thank him, I praise him, and I also praise Morehouse. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Montgomery. Senator Perkins on the resolution.
Thank you very much. I want to be brief, because I just wanted to, for the record, let it be clear that Major Owens was the congressman from Brooklyn, spent a lot of time with us in Harlem. And it was good time, because when we were struggling around hospital closings and anti-poverty programs closing, he was always available. And he was a role model for some of us who were looking forward to getting involved in community activism. And so I just wanted to let it be known that we appreciate him as if he was one of our congressmen as well.
Thank you, Senator Perkins. The question now is on resolution number 2758. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted.